We have just released the best bundle on the internet together with Film Riot, Cinecom, and a bunch of other top leading creators. We have put all of our best products into one huge bundle, and it's even crazier to say that we're discounting it at 95%. I'm not saying that you have to buy it, but I'm saying that you should check out the link in the description below and check it out for yourself. The crazy thing is, even if you only like one product, it's already a crazy good deal. Plus, you get a ton of other assets and courses to learn a ton from to create epic videos. It's honestly way better than Black Friday. See if this is something for you and check out the link in the description below. There is only one catch. This deal is only available for the next 5 days. Don't say I didn't warn you, and now let's start with this awesome effect. In last video, we checked out how to recreate the star scene from the Moon Knight series in Adobe After Effects, and in today's video, we're going to continue on that. Now we're going to transform into the Moon Knight. If you want to get more in detail on that, I would highly recommend you to also check out last week's video. All right, let's get into it. If you want an export from My3D renders, I will link them down below so you can use them in your own clips, however you want. All right, so how do we get started on this Moon Knight transformation? The first thing that I've done is recorded myself in the green screen room having this. Now we need to find ourselves a Moon Knight model, and either you're going to sculpt that yourself or you find an existing 3D model online. And due to us having not too much time, I preferred the second option. So what do we need to look for if we're looking for a 3D model? Because most 3D models are all textured onto the model itself. So to explain that in more detail, it's really important that we find a high detailed model where every single kind of silky, bendy cloth type line, the lines. So the thing is that all the wrap around the Moon Knight, the mummification effect, should be modeled and it shouldn't be textured. And in most models, it comes with a normal map, bump map, to make it look like it's mummified. To make it look like it's mummified.
But that's not what we want.
We need it to be modeled so we can extract each different element and bend them individually to make it look like it's actually wrapping around my face. So now I'm going to import my face into Cinema 4D. So I'm just going to import my footage into Cinema 4D. And here I'm going to place a 3D character model onto my face, just roughly the same model as me, to catch my shadow. So this is going to be my shadow catcher, and around that I want to add the Moon Knight. So for this Moon Knight, I searched a lot, but I couldn't find the detailed model that I wanted. So I tried to make my own, but I quickly realized it's going to take hell of a lot of time. So I kept on searching. And on YouTube, I found a channel that already sculpted the Moon Knight and actually gave this to his Patreon supporters for free. So that's really nice. And that's what I did. I joined his Patreon page and downloaded this Moon Knight model. And if you want to go and check out the artist, go and say hi for me. Link is in the description. All right, so thanks Caesar for this 3D model. All I've done with this 3D model is export it from Blender in Cinema, and then I detailed it a little bit more to my likings for my specific needs. I also took it into the sculpting tools and added even more detail, subdivided the model a little bit, and sculpted a little bit more detail on all the silky parts to make it look more organic and more detailed. Once I have my model, I also started texturing using Redshift Render Engine, which comes with Maxon 1. And then once you have your model, it's time to start with the animation. So now I place this model onto my face and I just isolated every single silky part from my face in a different layer. And now for this animation, all we need to make it do is to make it bend outwards and grow back inwards. So to do that, I used a bend deformer on every single object. So I just splitted each silk part and I added a bend deformer on that. You can also play with the jiggle deformer to have a little bit of delay. And that's also the exact same way I have done for the hood effect. So for the hood, it's all separate layers. So I basically deconstructed the whole model and have every part be separate. Then I also animated the position and rotation for the hood and also added a bend deformer with a jiggle deformer to have a little bit of bounce when it's animated on. All right, so now we have this animation of all these silky parts coming back together onto my face. There is just one more problem left, and that's that you can see the whole thing at all times. So what I wanted to do is actually to have it grow the silk while it's deforming and bending inwards. And to do that, we basically need to animate the opacity in the material node. And the best way that I found to do this is using vertex maps or weight maps, which you are going to be manipulating with fields in Cinema 4D. Cinema 4D is extremely powerful when it comes to playing with fields. You have so much control, and basically this allows you to create a growing effect onto your objects. And you can see right here, everything that is red shouldn't be visible. Everything that is yellow is going to be visible. So all I'm doing here is making an animation of this growing effect. And for this, I used a field sphere, which basically creates something like this. It's a lot of detail to go into this now, but you already grasped the basic concept. All right, so now we have this animated vertex map, and what you can do is actually link this vertex map into your opacity layer for your material. So I created a material for every single silk part. So you have 1 until 10, I think I had 10 different ones. And then in each opacity layer, I imported a different vertex map for each different object. All right, so this is basically just for the face, and then all I've done is export everything individually. You can use the multipasses in Redshift, which are really powerful for compositing. So I just export each scene separately, so I have full control in After Effects. Then in After Effects, I imported all these separate layers and composited them back together. And then playing around a little bit with everything, compositing everything nicely together, crappitizing your footage and making it blend together, you get something like this. All right, so that's quite a lot. I know this is more of an oversight video, but it's just too much detail. Hopefully you learned a thing or two from this process. And then also what we've done is the animation on the Moon Knight. And for this, we used the Rococo suit. The Rococo suit is really awesome and allows you to capture your entire motion and transform that onto a 3D character. And now we also have the Rococo smart gloves available, which are really awesome because they can actually follow your every single finger movement. And that makes the entire 3D model so much more detailed. So we record our motion and then we get back into Cinema. I already have my Moon Knight textured. I exported this as an FBX model and imported this on Mixamo.com. In Mixamo, I just used their auto rigger and then exported my model in its original pose back to Cinema. So to this character with the original pose, I didn't add any animation to it. I just wanted it to be rigged. And now in Cinema, you have this really cool feature that retargets your character animation. So when you have your pose on one character and you have your Rococo animation, which has the same kind of skeleton structure as the other one, you can just retarget them and it will just copy the animation from one rig to the other. And now my Moon Knight is animated. After all of this, if this wasn't enough, we also added some cloth dynamics. They are completely revamped and they go a lot faster than ever before. So I wanted to experiment with them as well. I added a little bit of wind and turbulence to make it feel like you're in the desert with a lot of wind. Then I exported this into Cinema and added the star field scene exactly like we've done in the previous video. Here I just added this into a 3D scene and also parented this to a 3D null that I exported from Cinema. You can do this using the composite tag and actually export a null with the 3D data from Cinema to Adobe After Effects. And yeah, so now we have all of this. I also retweaked a little bit of the previous shots that we have done in the previous video, such as this shot, I turned it into this shot. I added a little bit of a fake rim light around myself, just because we didn't record it perfectly on set, and this because we have a pretty small green screen room. And then I also added some fake lighting flashes, so it actually looks like the scene is interacting with the light from the sky while it's spinning around. And yeah, it's just giving a little bit more of a realistic vibe. Also adding screen shake and stuff like that brings us to the final result. Enjoy. right, and that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel for more and hit the notification bell to stay notified when I upload new videos. Apart from that, I'm going to leave you with the last video, which you can see right here. And apart from that, I hope to see you in the next one. Create epic videos.